G'day boys and girls, it's day number two of our Easter Bible Club. We're going to sing two songs, and then we're going to sing Hosanna at the very end. In the middle of our story today, we have an episode with a little donkey. I jumped on the donkey. The question is, did I stay on the donkey? Sing along! What's next here? Do you know this one? Have you heard? Wonderful. Absolutely marvelous. Sing along.
Have you heard the marvelous? Absolutely marvelous. Awesome, brilliant, fabulous news about Jesus. How a great time for me. Take my sin and set me free. Have you heard the wonderful news?
Absolutely.
let's go to our story. It's the Easter story. Wonderful, wonderful story. The most amazing story in the whole world. The greatest love story ever. What a wonderful ending, a wonderful happy ending at the very, very end. So yesterday, if you were following, we talked about the birth and the reason the Lord Jesus had to come into the world. The Bible says Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. By being born wasn't enough, living wasn't enough, Jesus needed to die. So he's got 12 disciples, he's been doing earthly ministry for about 3 years, and he says to the disciples, I must needs go into Jerusalem. And I'm going to walk through the streets on a little donkey. And in 2 days' time, they're going to turn against me. And they're going to crucify me on the cross. And the disciples could not understand why he would say such a thing. He said, go and outside the little house, a little stable, outside tied is a little colt. A little colt is a baby donkey. He said, no one has ever ridden that donkey before, but go and get him for me. So they go, and the man, the owner, says, excuse me, what are you doing with my donkey? And they said, the Lord Jesus has asked to borrow him. He said, that's okay. And they said, we'll bring him back. We'll bring him back to you. And boys and girls, this is a colt. And if those men were to jump on this donkey, you can be certain that little donkey would buck him straight off. But when Jesus was going to sit on this donkey, nothing was going to happen. And I don't know about you, when I was a wee boy, we had a donkey. My brothers and I had a donkey. And for some reason, every time you jumped on his back, he always bucked you off. And that was a game we loved to play. You'd sneak up behind him and jump on his back and he'd just buck. And you'd fall off or fall off the side of the back, or he'd put his head down and you'd tumble over the front. And that was a game, a fun time we had. But I'm kind of going to show you a little video now. It's very short. Just last night, I thought, I wonder, can I ride the donkey? The same donkey I tried at Christmas time. And I thought, it's easy. It's a small donkey. It's a strong donkey. And I'm just going to go, and I'm going to jump on his back. And here's what happened. In the Easter story, Jesus sat on a donkey. No one was ever on before. And he walked straight into Jerusalem. Now, I can't go to Jerusalem, but I can certainly jump on a donkey. Here we go. Woohoo! Oh! No! Ah! I couldn't do it. Next time. I hope you're not laughing at me. Oh, I could not stay on. The moment I sat on him, I was about to talk to him, and he took off like a rocket. And I thought he was going to round the bank and I fell off the side. Next time, maybe next time. Joanna thinks I'm mad. And my dad say, you should act your age, not your shoe size. So there you go. Anyway, they took the little donkey to Jesus. And the moment the Lord Jesus sat on this animal, immediately he took control of it. And it was tame. It never bucked him. He just walked. And I thought, the Lord Jesus, he could have chosen a lion, a tiger, or any animal he wanted, an elephant, to walk through Jerusalem, because he could control any one of them, or a big beautiful white horse or black stallion, but he chose a little donkey. And he just says the little donkey walking. That wee donkey's walking. Imagine the little donkey thinking he could have chosen any other animal, but yet he chose me to carry Jesus. And I thought, boys and girls, the Lord just doesn't choose the wealthy people, the intelligent people, the smart people, the fit people. No. The Bible says he chooses the foolish things of this world. The people who maybe think they've no potential. The people think who there's no real plan for them in this life. Maybe they feel rejected or there's no real plan for God. God said, little children, give me your heart and give me your life. If you're willing to do something for me, to live for me, to shine for me, I will be willing to use you. And just like a little donkey, all the little donkey did was to carry Jesus. And that's all he wants us to do, to carry the name of Jesus into this world. Whether we're at school or whether we're at home, whether it's live in school or through YouTube or however, he just says, take my name wherever you go. And the wee donkey's traveling, but the wee donkey couldn't understand because everyone is crying, Hosanna, we love you. And they're taking off their coats and they just love Jesus. But the wee donkey probably felt, why is Jesus not happy? Why is he so solemn and so sad? Because the Lord Jesus, as he looked on the people, he saw the innocence of the children, but he saw the adults, and he knew these people, they just wanted Jesus to be king, because Jesus could give them food, he could do miracles, he could do parables, he could heal people, help people, feed people, do all those things. But Jesus said, that's not why I came to this world. He said, I came to die for the sins of the world. And whenever he was able to tell them that, they would just say, away with him. We no longer want anything to do with Jesus. So boys and girls, that's the wee donkey. And if the wee donkey can use you, God Jesus could use the wee donkey, then what could God do with you? What can he do with me if we just been willing to take the name of Jesus everywhere you go? And what happened? Well, the little children, the Lord Jesus absolutely loved him, and the religious leaders, the scribes and Pharisees, even though they knew all about God on the outside, they hated the Lord Jesus on the inside. They were jealous of him. They didn't want anything to do with him. But every time they tried to capture him, he was always around the people. He loved him, and especially the children. So they were waiting for their opportunity to capture the Lord Jesus, to try and punish him and put him to death. The Lord Jesus said to the disciples, we need to meet. We're going to have supper. It's going to be our last supper together. So he said, go along the street. You'll find a man carrying a pitcher of water. Follow him. And wherever he stops, there's a door, there's stairs, go up the stairs, and there's an upper room, we're going to meet there, and we're going to have a feast. And the Lord Jesus, sometime after he met all 12 disciples, see, everyone was coming to Jerusalem for a special the Easter time. It was the feast of the Passover. If you go way back in the beginning of the Bible, Genesis, Exodus, whenever the Israelites were brought into Egypt, after all those years, remember Moses, he brought them out. That whenever, and then the last plague, there was 10 plagues. The final plague was the blood of the lamb. And the death angel came and said, when I, the Lord, shall see the blood, I will pass over you. And that night, all of them could be saved. And the great escape happened as he escaped through from Egypt, through the Red Sea, into the wilderness, to the promised land. So once a year, they would all come to Jerusalem. And that's what they would have their feast or celebration. But the religious leaders couldn't get Jesus because so many people were all around him. But Jesus said, tonight, they're going to arrest me. And they're going to put me to death on the cross. I'm going to die for the sins of the world. And they all said, they all began to say, Lord, who's your favorite disciple? Which one of us is the greatest amongst you, amongst all of us? And the Lord said, I'm about to die. They're going to capture me and put me to death. And you're asking yourself, who's the greatest? So Jesus took a towel and began to wash their feet. That was a very humiliating job for the Lord to do. See, you must understand the culture here. They lived in very dusty. I've been to some of this country in Israel and other countries. And it's very customary when you go in somewhere, they would offer you a basin of water and they would wash your feet. Because just like when you go to someone's house, they would say, can I take your coat? Would you like to wash your hands? Would you like to use the bathroom? Well, in these countries, because it's so dusty and you're walking with sandals, the dust gets into your feet, so they would like to wash your feet. Normally a servant would do that. But Jesus has taken the place of a servant with a towel washing their feet. Peter said, Lord, I don't want you to wash my feet. You shouldn't be washing people's feet. Jesus said, Peter, if I can't wash your feet, I want nothing to do with you. Peter said, Lord, wash my hands, wash my head, wash my body, wash my feet. And then Peter said, Lord, nobody's going to hurt you. Nobody's going to harm you. I will make sure, I will protect you. Peter was a big, strong fisherman. Jesus said, Peter, do you see before tomorrow morning, you're going to deny me three times. Denying is saying, I don't even know who you are. Peter said, Lord, I would never do that once, never mind three times. You will, Peter. And whatever you do, the rooster's going to crow three times and you will just remember you've just denied me. Furthermore, Jesus said, one of you is going to betray me. You're going to sell me for money as if you didn't know me. And you all began to say, is it me? Is it I? Lord, who is it? Judas spoke up. He said, Lord, it is. Judas, is you, and whatever you're going to do it quickly. So what does Judas do? Judas gets up and takes his money back. He was a traitor. Judas was not a true disciple. Even though he looked like the rest of them. He knew all about God, knew all about Jesus, but his heart was dark with sin. He had never asked God to forgive him. He was never a born-again Christian. And Jesus said, Judas, whatever you're going to do, do it quickly. And everyone thought Jesus was sending Peter out to buy more bread, to go and feed the poor. None of them even realized what Judas was going to do. He was with Jesus for 3 years, every day. And do you know where he went? He went to find the religious leaders who were plotting to capture and kill Jesus. And Judas said, I know where he is. Tonight I know exactly where he's going to be. He's going to be all alone. Because Jesus never had an address. The Bible says the Son of Man had nowhere to lay his head. He had nothing in this world. He was born with nothing, he owned nothing, and he left this world with nothing, and he owns the whole world. Think about that one. And Judas said, if you pay me money, 30 pieces of silver, I will take you exactly where he's going to be. And they gave him the money. In the meantime, Jesus says to the disciples, let's go into the Garden of Gethsemane and let's pray. And he says, will you sit up with me and pray for 1 hour? And as Jesus began to pray, the disciples fell asleep. And Jesus said, please wake up just for 1 hour. Pray with me. And they said, okay. And they began to pray and they closed their eyes again. They were tired. Jesus said, all alone, just went to the side. And he began to pray, Father, in heaven, is there any other way you can take away this pain of the sin of the world? And God said to his son, Jesus, there's no other way. You must go all the way to the cross. And the Bible says, as Jesus was praying, he began to sweat, and his sweat turned into great sweat drops of blood. And he became so weak, God sent an angel down to encourage him, to comfort him, to feed him. When the disciples fell asleep. And then as the Lord Jesus was praying and just sitting there, suddenly heard a noise, and he looked up, and loads of soldiers, all the religious leaders, Judas was leading them into the Garden of Gethsemane, and Judas said, I'm going to go, and the one I kiss in the cheek is Jesus Christ. Even though the Lord Jesus, he looked the same as all the rest of his dark, but Judas knew exactly. See, the little children were all fast asleep, so they said, we'll get him tonight. When the children were sleeping, they went off into the garden with their torches, their swords, and their spears. And Jesus said to Judas, friend, what are you doing? Judas didn't care. He just loved his money. And they're going to do something really, really terrible to the Lord Jesus. And he's going to go through an awful lot of pain to conquer the sin of the world. My sin and your sin. Do you want to know what he done with Jesus? We'll tell you tomorrow. Tomorrow. Anyway, we've got a quiz. And then we might show you that wee donkey again. Yes. Here's a quiz. It's Easter time, so we thought we'd have some Easter eggs. Yes. Love Easter eggs. Next Tuesday, I'm going to show you how to eat an Easter egg. You remember. Tuesday, we're going to do an Easter egg hunt. Yes. Right. So pick the numbers, 1 to 9. Girls, this week are we talking about the Christmas story or the Easter story? Easter, well done. Number 5. Okay. 30. Boys, at Easter time, is it about Jesus being born or Jesus dying? Dying, that's right. What number? 3. I have no idea what these are. We're just picking random ones. Girls, whenever we think of the disciples, how many disciples were there? 12. Yes, number 7. Ooh, good girls. Boys, whenever we think about the disciples, which disciple was going to deny Jesus? Peter. Well done. Oh, Peter. So it's number 1. 20. Girls, which disciple betrayed Jesus, sold him for money? Judas, that's right. Number 9. Ooh, 20. Boys, how much money did Judas betray Jesus for? 30 pieces of silver, that's right. Number 4. 50, okay, let's add these up. Boys have got 170 and girls have got 200. Girls are winning. Final egg. Girls, whenever we think of Jesus, what did he begin to do to teach the disciples a lesson? Because they were talking how important they are. He began to wash their hands or their ears or their feet. What was it? Their feet. That's right. Pink. Girls like pink. What have we got? 40. 240 for the girls. Boys, you needed a big one here. Boys, whenever we think of the Lord Jesus and he met the disciples in the upper room, then he said, let's go to the garden. Does anyone remember the name of the garden? They're called the Garden of Gethsemane. That's right. Number 2. 45. No, you got 205. Girls got 240. Girls, they are the winners. What was the last one worth? 50? Girls would have still won. Okay, let's sing a final. Oh, let me tell you about the competition. Sorry, the competition's here. The competition finishes 4 o'clock today. We're talking about the Easter story. It's all this week, the Easter Bible Club. And the competition is to do with eggs. You can get an egg and paint the egg, or get a piece of paper and just, you can paint draw a picture on the piece of paper, or and put them in by 4 o'clock today, your colourful eggs, your picture with Easter story, and this is where you send it to BibleFunWeek@gmail.com, Messenger, or the WhatsApp number by 4 o'clock today. Then we'll hopefully show these tomorrow for you. Let's sing a final song, and this song is going to be called Hosanna. Remember the cry, Hosanna? Really good song. Then we'll see the donkey one at the end. About Hosanna. Just before we go, we're going to finish with me getting on the donkey again. In the Easter story, Jesus sat on a donkey no one was ever on before, and he walked straight into Jerusalem. Now, I can't go to Jerusalem, but I can certainly jump on a donkey. Here we go. Woohoo! Oh! No! Next time.